Well, psychologist Jane McCartney joins us now. That's brilliant. I love the idea that she's got grid references in her mind.
It is, yes.
Once past the dirty knickers, left at the coffee cup, and find your homework, you know.
But teenagers are not programmed. This is not on their agenda to think, I've got to keep my room tidy. Mm. You know, I'm thinking about texting my friends, I'm thinking about maybe a little bit of homework, I'm thinking about who I'm going to go and meet at the weekend. Tidying my room is just not on their agenda.
It does seem like something weird happens, doesn't it? You can have this like perfectly sweet, cute little girl or perfectly doting little boy at the age of about 10, and then somewhere around 13, carnage sets in.
It is.
You know, what is it? Is it simply hormones? Is it simply part of a growing up?
It is hormones, but it's also, you know, there's a lot of research to say that how the brain develops, how a teenage brain develops. And the bits of the brain, the prefrontal cortex, that are the, if you like, the pleasure-seeking areas, develop faster than the actual kind of reasonable, the rational bits of the brain. So it's a bit like having a well-developed accelerator in a car, but not such a well-developed brake. So, you know, the bits that want to just, you know, I need to get out, I need to dress up nicely, I need to get out. I'm not going to think about all the tons of clothes that I've just shoved under the bed, on the bed, you know, behind the wardrobe.
Okay.
That bit doesn't matter.
Are you saying that untidy people are basically very intelligent?
They're not unintelligent.
Oh, I thought I had a breakthrough there for a minute, but apparently not.
As Siobhan's just demonstrated, you know, she's obviously a very bright
exactly
girl.
Exactly, front of the youth parliament.
Yeah,
very bright girl. So it's maybe it's priorities, and if you're saying the teenage priorities aren't for organisation, they've got their
they're
own
not.
Order in their head. So what do we do about it then as parents, if you're a mum, if you're poor Amanda there, trying to deal with that mess?
Well,
best just to let it go?
Well, there is an argument to say accept it because it's not going to last forever. Mm. At some point or other, they will go off to university or leave home, and you can get in there with a bulldozer, absolutely, and you know, find the toxic socks and things, and you know, sort of send them off to Portland Down or something. But it's a case of negotiating with them, bribing them. You know, if say Siobhan wants credit for her phone, yes, you can have an extra £10 credit if you such and such. You know, be fairly straightforward, blunt, stick to the issues. You know, when you're having arguments about the room, stick to the arguments about the room. Don't start talking about who she's seeing at night and what she's doing at night.
Just focus on
focus on those issues.
Mm.
And then listen as well.
And can I just also say help as well? Because I am slightly disorganised. And it comes down to actually not knowing how to do it a lot of the time.
But
help
you don't
them
have to
do
put
it.
Your clothes away.
Well, help us
or
to
fold them up. You
I'm not getting into this, we're out of
bin.
Time. But, you know, sometimes you have to talk through with a youngster, I think, what to do to keep things tidy. I'm struggling here, aren't I? You've been brilliant, though. Thank you very much, Shadi. Lots of good advice there. Do keep sending your pictures off.
Well, yes and no. I would say it changes every year as well. We talk about debts, we talk about how many days it's been since our last payday before Christmas, and the time seems to stretch out even more every year. But it's, as the lady said in the piece before, it's personal, it's what you take of it, it's what you can do with it.
There's a lot of pressure in January, not just in terms of money, but also the pressure we put on ourselves to be new and improved. What should we be doing to make our lives a bit easier?
Absolutely. Not putting pressure on yourself. I'm saying, if you want to lose weight, if you want to learn French, whatever it is you want to do, fine, do it. But don't feel that you have to do it specifically now. There's nothing to say that you can't do this, say, at the beginning of March or at the end of May or something. If there's something you want to achieve this year, then set about to achieve it, but don't have to achieve it all in January.
Some of the people we saw in Bicester seem naturally more optimistic than others. If your glass is always half empty, how can you make it half full?
Well, you've got to remember, with the glass half empty and the glass half full, it's always the same amount of liquid in the glass. You've got to think about it like that. The things to do if you are feeling a little bit blue, a little bit gloomy, get yourself out, exercise. It's the thing that releases the serotonin level, which is, you know, the brain's natural feel-good chemical. Read a good book, nothing too miserable, you know, and as the doctor from Cardiff University said, maybe stay in with a film, but not too much, but make sure it's a cheerful film.
Jane McCartney, thank you.
You're welcome.